And welcome back. Jay Sekulow is not only one of President Trump's attorneys, he also heads up the American Center for Law and Justice and hosts his own radio and TV programs. Now, in his spare time, he's also one of Israel's greatest defenders and advocates. Jay's latest book is Jerusalem, a biblical and historical case for the Jewish capital. As you'll see, it's one case that's open and shut. Take a look. You wanted to argue the case for Jerusalem like a Supreme Court case.
Yep.
Tell us what you mean by that.
Well, you know, there's been a lot of great books written about Israel, Israel's right to exist, Israel in biblical history. And so there's a lot of great material out there. But I wanted to present the case for the legal case, the political case, the theological case for the existence of Jerusalem as the eternal capital of the Jewish people, the capital of Israel. But I presented it like a legal argument. The legal basis, I looked at the law. What is the law on governments declaring a capital of their homeland? The law was clear. When you look at international law, same thing. When you look at the evidence, what is the evidence here? You have the archaeological evidence. You have the evidence of Scripture. So you have the theological case, the biblical case for Israel. But when you put all of it together in one book, which we did in our book, Jerusalem, what we did was give a comprehensive defense for Israel's right to declare its homeland to be the state of Israel, but also Jerusalem to be its eternal capital.
I'm sure you've discussed this with the president, with Vice President Pence.
Yeah.
What is their take on Jerusalem? It seems like they really get it. They get the importance of Jerusalem.
Well, they wanted to take off the table what has been consistently a stumbling block issue with any kind of peace discussions, and that was the area of Jerusalem. Now, of course, the president lets it to the Israelis to decide their borders. That's what a sovereign nation does. But what the president has done from the outset of this was recognize that by taking Jerusalem and acknowledging what is already fact, that Jerusalem is the capital of Israel, that that eliminates it as this kind of fake bargaining chip, a bargaining employee, if you will, that was being utilized by the Palestinian Authority. Now, you've got the complication, Erick, and you've covered this so well for so many years between, you know, the Fatah and Hamas and this coalition government that they kind of have and really don't have. But at the end of the day, I mean, what we wanted to see happen here, and the president implemented it, was a put in place the United States recognition of what I would call the obvious, and that is that Jerusalem is, in fact, the capital of Israel. Remember all of the discussion that there was going to be this eruption in the Muslim world over this. Did not happen. Mm-hmm. There was going to be increased terror attacks, and really did not happen. And the fact is that the Jordanians and the Egyptians and the Saudis and the Gulf states know that having a relationship and an ally in Israel right now is really critical. And you had this unique, you've covered this, this unique coalescing of the Middle East, and they recognize that the Palestinian problem needs to be resolved, but the Palestinian leadership has to get out of the way to allow it to be resolved. And what I've done in the book is establish not only what has, in fact, happened by our recognition in the United States, but more important than that, that this was God's plan from the beginning, and equally significant, and just for as far as writing it was going, to look at that archaeological evidence, which, you know, as you know, you go to Israel a lot. I mean, every day it's a new discovery. You know, it's not a gigantic city, as you know. I mean, Jerusalem, its circumference and what it covers would be a medium-sized city in the United States. But yet it is, as you said, the most coveted real estate in the world. So, of course, you're always going to have competing clashes to obtain that property. It's been since time immemorial, since the beginning of recorded mankind history, Jerusalem has been a focal point of conflict and conquest. By the way, God is in the real estate business. You know, that's the frequent mantra on the other side is that God's not in the real estate business. Well, actually, read the scriptures. It's always going to be a point of conflict, and we just have to, as God's people, have to be able to defend the right of that land to exist as the Jewish homeland.
Thanks again to Jay Sekulow for joining us. You can pick up Jerusalem, a biblical and historical case for the Jewish capital, wherever books are sold. Well, coming up after the break, we head to the Museum of the Bible in Washington, D.C. for a taste of Jerusalem. What do I mean? Find out after the break.